In this video, we are going to start our second unit, that is manufacturing process. So first of all, starting with this unit, some basic things we should know. What is meant by manufacturing process? So first of all, we have to see that why we should learn the manufacturing process. What is the use to learn the manufacturing process? Now, in day-to-day life, why we are using the different types of products, such as mobiles are there, tables are there, chairs are there. This day-to-day life, we are using these components or products. So these are products developed from some raw material for welfare of human being. So for human comfort, these products are developed. So to this manufacturing process, a term is developed. It is called as the man's material welfare. It is called as the MMW. Now there is one certain formula. MMW is equal to NR into HE raised to tools. So what is this MMR, MMW, NR, HE, that we'll see. NR, MMW means men's material welfare. So this men's material welfare is equal to NR. NR means availability of natural resources. So such as air is there, water is there, heat is there, light, plants, animals, solid and liquid minerals. So from natural resources, you are going to form the products. So that is a NR, natural resources. HE, that is a human effort. So you have to put some human effort on the raw material to develop certain products. So human effort is HE. And it may be a physical or it may be a mental. If a product is developed by some software analysis, then it will be mental. Some you have to put some effort, such as you have to manufacture tables or chairs from wood. From raw wood is there, you have to manufacture from the wood. So you have to put some physical efforts. So these efforts may be a physical, it may be a mental. And it is a race to tools. Tools means you have to convert raw wood into a chair. So you have to use some tools, such as hacksaw you have to use, hammers you have to use. So these tools are rest to human effort. So you have to make use of tools and you have to put some effort, and that wood is available naturally. So MMW is equal to NR into HE, rest to tools. Then what is mean by manufacturing process? Now this manufacturing process, the term is developed from the Latin word. Latin words are manus. Manus means it is a hand, and factus. Factus means it is a making. So combination of hand and making, that is a made by the hand. The components are made by the hand. These are called as the manufacturing process. So you can define it in this way, the manufacturing process. So the process which convert raw material into the finished product with the help of some machine, some tools or equipment, it is called as a manufacturing process. So you can write the definition like this: it converts raw material into finished product, called as the production process, or it is also called as the manufacturing process. So in this process, there are different types of machines, tools, equipments you can use to convert a raw thing into the finished good. So goal of this manufacturing process is to give a component which we can use in particular application. Now there are different types of manufacturing processes are there: casting process, forging process, joining process, forming process, machining process. This process we can use or we can study. Now, which are the different materials we can use in the manufacturing? one is the metal, thermoplastic, composite, semiconductor, then ceramics are there, thermoplast are there, thermosettings are there, polymers are there. From these material we can process, we can do some work on this, and we can achieve a finished product. So it is called as the materials in the manufacturing. So first we are going to see the casting process. Now casting, it is a process in which a liquid material is usually poured into a mold, and the mold is of desired shape, and then it is allowed to solidify. So basically we'll see first the different application of the casting. In casting process, a metal is melted till its liquid form, then it is poured or it is inserted in the required cavity or required shape to fill the cavity, and then it is allowed to solidify, and then the casting is break, and you can get the required shape. So there are certain steps are there in the casting. First step in the casting is the melting a metal in the suitable furnace. You have to melt the metal in the furnace till its liquid form. Then a molten metal is poured in the predefined cavity. A cavity is there of required shape. In that required shape cavity, a melted metal is poured or it is inserted. Then molten metal is allowed to solidify. Then that metal which is poured in the cavity, it is allowed to solidify. Till the solidification, you have to wait. Then removal of cast part from the mold. Then after solidification, that casting is get break, and that solidify mold or that part is removed from the casting, and then finishing is done or polishing is done. Now there are certain steps are there before these steps in the casting. What you have to do before the casting process is done? First is pattern making, core making, molding, then melting and pouring the metal in the cavity, and then cleaning. So this is basically a diagram. Now here two boxes are there. Bottom box is called as the drag, upper box is called as the core. Now there is certain opening is there in the cope. So you can see here funnel shape part, this is a conical shape part is there. Then this vertical channel is there. Inside this channel a molten metal is poured. Then from this vertical part, molten metal is carried out from this horizontal channel to this mold. Now this is the required shape. This is the required shape that we want, and in that particular shape a molten metal is inserted via this channel. And from the right side you can see again funnel shape part is there, again this opening is there, it is called as the riser. So one by one we'll see the function. So this is a funnel shape part. From funnel shape part a molten metal is poured inside the cavity. So funnel shape part is given so that a molten metal is directed inside the cavity. So this upper part is called as the spur, S-P-U-R. It is not mentioned here. Vertical channel is called as spur. This horizontal channel is called as the runner, and the opening where this horizontal channel opens in this cavity is called as the gate. And on the right side this vertical channel is called as the riser. So when you are inserting a molten metal inside the cavity, this is the cavity. So molten metal is gets inside the cavity. When cavity is get full, when this cavity is get fully filled by the molten metal, then the molten metal will comes up from this riser. So when molten metal comes from the riser, you can know that our cavities get filled. Then you can stop the pouring the molten metal. So upper box is called as a cope, lower box is called as a drag, and the line which separates these two boxes is called as the parting line. Now you can see here in more clear way, this box, there is one cavity, you can see white color cavity that we want, this shape we want as a final product. On the extreme right side, you can see that this is a pouring cup, conical shape part is given, it is called as a pouring cup or funnel shape part. This vertical channel is called as the spur, S-P-R-U-E. This horizontal channel is called as the runner. This vertical channel is called as the riser. Again, this vertical channel is called as the gas vent. Upper box is called as the cope, lower box is called as the drag. So when you insert a molten metal inside this pouring cup or funnel shape part, it will move from pouring cup to spur. Spur is a vertical channel, then a horizontal channel is called as a runner, then it will enter in the mold cavity. This is a blank cavity. Now as molten metal is in the liquid form, it will be heated, so some gases will be generated. So these gases will leave this cavity to the surrounding with the help of gas vent. Gas vent is the small openings. And when this cavity is get fully filled by the molten metal, then metal will rise from the riser to the outside. So you can know that the cavity is get filled. Then you have to wait for till the solidification. Now we'll see one small video. Now two boxes are there, we know lower box is called as a drag, upper box is called as a cope. Now initially we have to make a pattern, so two patterns are made, one half pattern in the drag, half pattern in the cope. This video you can easily find on the YouTube. Then sand is inserted in the both boxes to get a cavity. Sand is inserted, then pressure is applied on the sand so that it is get compacted. Then these patterns are removed so that half pattern will get in the drag, half pattern you can get in the cope. Then cope box is placed on the drag, so both half patterns will get a full pattern. Now you can see that two openings are there, this is one opening and this another opening. So these both boxes are get clamped. So two openings are there, one is for inserting a molten metal, so it is called as the spur, or it is called as a funnel shape part, and from other it is called as the riser. So a molten metal is poured from funnel shape part or a pouring cup, or it is also called as a spur. And when it is get cavities get filled from other opening, a liquid will come out so that you can know the cavities get filled. Then till solidification you have to wait. After solidification the casting is get break. And then you can get a final shape. Then this final shape we can get. And after machining you can remove the unwanted part and finish product will get. So this is the called as the sand casting. So this is the another figure of sand casting. Now there are different disadvantages, advantage of sand casting. Different applications are there, such as motor housing, then crane hooks, turbine blades, pump housing, your two-wheeler, four-wheeler tire rims, flanges are made by the casting process. That is supplement. There are some disadvantages, advantages, such as advantages. Complex structures we can manufacture by the casting process. Then size does not matter. Small size, bigger size component we can manufacture. Higher compressive strengths are there. Skilled person is not required. You have to just mold the metal and pouring inside the cavity. Then cheapest process is there. Scrap can be recycled. If scrap is there, you can melt and again you can use. Some disadvantages are there. Surface finish of product is very poor, and accuracy is also, we cannot get exact value or exact dimension by using the casting process. Then labor cost is high because you have to work with the heat, so labor cost is high. For mass production, it is not, we cannot use this manufacturing process. Then selection criteria for casting process, special requirements are there, such as magnetism if it is required, corrosion in case of corrosion, stress distribution. These factors also influence in the choice of the metal casting process. Then costing is also important. Then economics of machines versus process cost. Then adequate protection, packaging, shipping constraint, regulations of the final component, weights and life of the component. Then protective coatings if it is required. Then it also plays a major role in the metal casting process. So these are some glimpse of the manufacturing processes. Next process we will see in the next video. Thank you.